have with us this morning on Hot Copy, Iloilo Representative and former Health Secretary Janet Garin. Secretary, Secretary, Congresswoman Garin, good morning.
Good morning, Karen.
All right. I've read that you see no problem in Kaskolan's appointment as Health Undersecretary. Is this correct?
Yes, I've seen him as the PNP chief, and I've seen him rose from the ranks. I really don't know him that close, but knowing the Department of Health, it's not just about doctors and scientists. That's basically one of the gaps that we need to address, because technical inputs will always be there, but making those technical inputs applicable and felt by the people is another problem. Most of the doctors are actually not managers. And that's why in many countries, the secretaries of health are non-doctors. In the Philippines, it has been part of tradition that the sitting secretary of health is a medical doctor. In this case, an undersecretary being appointed who is a non-doctor is something that is not new. In fact, in many other countries, former military officers who have had vast experience in management, finance, and implementation of programs have been appointed as ministers of health. And we're talking about Singapore, I believe Spain, even Poland, Ireland, Indonesia. In fact, Israel, a country that has been a frontliner in medical innovations. The sitting secretary of health is a non-doctor. Why? Because there will always be nuances and problems among doctors, various opposing technical inputs. And usually the one who would go in between should be a non-doctor so that he would be a non-biased, he would have an unbiased outlook.
Okay. Well, actually, what amazes me is how you've justified his appointment by saying that you have no problem with it. I get that. But then I'll give you another question. Why him? What makes him so special? There are so many people in the Philippines who are qualified for that job, who are non-doctors. But why him? Why get a former PNP chief, frankly speaking, one with such a controversial history? Why him?
Wala na bang galing sa Pilipinas? I mean, frankly speaking. Unang-una, it's an executive prerogative. Now, the controversial aspect that... I just heard recently from the news is that the involvement in the war against drugs. No? So I really haven't heard the extent of such. Now, moreover, yes, we have been hearing comments from the left-leaning health workers.
Left-leaning alone. It's an issue of there is no permanent health secretary right now. After the COVID pandemic, you choose an undersecretary that's coming from the PNP without genuine track record on health. So it behooves the question for ordinary citizens, why him?
Well, Karen, we have to separate the issue of a secretary from an undersecretary, because the way I see things, all of these questions are coming in because everybody is clamoring for the president, or not everybody, but some are clamoring for the president to appoint a secretary of health. But that should be separated. I was commenting as a former secretary of health because nakita ko po ang problema sa loob din. Let's say when we talk about calamities response, dealing with LGUs is not that easy. We have programs, policies, and when doctors and our experts would go to governors and mayors, there are sometimes strong resistance. With a former military officer, that response of the DOH can be coupled by a respect among colleagues in the PNP. So when he goes to a certain area, there is already an existing platform where he can communicate with local government chief executives, because health is a devolved institution. That's one of the biggest loophole that we have, or barrier that we have in terms of health services. Coupled with that, pag may calamity, pupuntang DOH. Hirap na hirap. So I'm not sure, but what I am looking is the possibility that when DOH goes there, we have their former head of the PNP also coming there, then you already have workers on the grounds by PNP helping the health personnel implement their programs. Not all tasks of the DOH is handled by a medical technical person. Minsan nga nagkaka-problema yung ganon, because technical scientists and doctors would always have their huge and very important role. But cascading that down is always more often foreign to many of the scientists. So I'm on a personal note, that why him, marami ang qualified. Well, maybe we can put up names who applied, because yes, there are a lot of qualified people, but we also have a problem of many doctors not accepting any health post. That's the reality. I mean, on a personal...
I want to ask you, you've been in government, you've been health secretary, you're now in Congress. This is not the first time that, as you've said, it's good he's a military man. But there have been so many times that military men have been appointed in several agencies of government, and it didn't have to be military men. And frankly, were they all that effective? This is not the
some were effective, some were not. But if you look at the situation, the missing link there is always the input of technical expertise. Yung iba kasi, pag na-appoint at nabibigyan ng position, they will get individual persons as their advisors, yung mga kaibigan, kakilala. Mm-hmm. If General Cascolan will ask me, I will seriously advise him that his advisors should be based on specialty medical societies or even the Philippine Medical Association. And even people in the Department of Health, we have a lot of technical directors inside and technical scientists and experts inside the Department of Health na yung mga bosses nila hindi makalabas. Ang daming magagaling sa loob, pero hindi makalabas.
So you said it yourself, ang daming magaling sa loob. While this is the president's prerogative, aren't there career officials within the DOH that are talented enough, skilled enough to be undersecretary?
Well, Karen, we have to realize na karamihan ng mga magagaling na scientists sa loob would not like to be casual officials of the government. If they will be appointed as undersecretary, anytime pwedeng tanggalin at palitan yan. Mm-hmm. Kaya walang tumatanggap eh. That's one of the problems. Pangalawa, ang totoo niyan, karamihan ng mga doktor, almost all doctors are refusing posts in government because they sense that there are a lot of pwede ka kasing takutin ng mga kaso. Remember, undersecretaries, assistant secretaries, government officials, ASEC and above, you will be forced to handle procurement issues. And if there are suppliers, usually what happens, a lot of lawyers would barge in. Kaya takot na takot yung mga doktor, kaya walang tumatanggap eh. The question here is not about, do we have a lot of qualified people? Yes, we have. But the bigger question is, would they accept the post? Because as I know, the position of Secretary of Health has been offered to many qualified individuals already. But they don't want to give up their practice. Marami ang takot. Kasi baka mamaya ubusin kami ng kaso dyan. Kawawa naman yung aming pamilya. There are a lot of circumstances that has actually paved way for many doctors to fear government service.
And in a way like yourself, I mean, let's go to you on that. Just specifically, you had to face your own cases after that very controversial Dengvaxia issue, which then you were at some point proven right that many countries in the world had actually used it. So that's one, right?
And on top of that, Karen, marami pong mga doktor ang nagkakaroon ng kaso because of procurement issues. Hmm. And there are also a lot of doctors who would like to implement something because that is mandated by law or mandated by the department. But when they go down, because it's a devolved healthcare system, they cannot fully implement and exercise their technical expertise because they cannot communicate well with LGU officials. Okay. And mind you, even with COVID vaccination, akala namin, just because of dengue vaccine, our scientists and experts, we have a lot of good career people in the Department of Health na ando doon magagaling. But because nadamay, no? Maski walang kinalaman, dinamay sa dengue scare, no, they are all there and they are not being appointed. And many have resigned. And ang nakalimutan ko lang, Karen, I'm not sure if this is right because we heard it from medical experts. Even our scientists and doctors involved in the COVID vaccination of children and teenagers also ended up with cases. This is COVID vaccination. This is not dengue. Kinasuhan lahat. So sino tatanggap?
So Congressman, Congresswoman, let's go back to that a little later on. I'll ask you about the Alliance for Health Workers, the statement that they had issued out. I mean, clearly, President Marcos Jr. is very popular with a very strong mandate. But does this endear him to the stakeholders, which are the health workers, right? So the Alliance for Health Workers has said, it shows, and I'm quoting, this is from the statement, the president's lack of concern for their lives, health, safety, and welfare of health workers. So ang unang tanong, should he have at least, yes, hindi naman ito secretary, USEC lang ito, ilan ba ang USEC, Congresswoman ng DOH? Tatlo ba?
I think, I think five or six.
Oh,
and
lima.
Pwede kasi siyang dagdagan eh. It can even go up to 10. Nagdadagdag lang. These are positions under the office of the president. Yung ibang dinadagdag. Karen, I fully respect the Alliance of Health Workers. In fact, I know many of them. However, I believe the nuance or the conflict is arising from the fact that we have a former military officer, meron kasi yung ano eh, meron kasi yung konting, how will I say, there's a conflict in some of the idealism that the Alliance of Healthcare Workers and some of the military officers. So meron yung sinasabi natin nakaraan. But we also have a lot, let's talk about the welfare of health workers. You were saying na hindi nirerespeto ng presidente yung the allegations
not
na
me.
Walang
no,
concern.
No, not me. I'm reading the Alliance
of
Health Workers statement.
Sorry for that.
Yeah, yeah.
I was referring to the statement.
Yeah.
But the undersecretary that has been appointed is not the head of human resource. You have an existing undersecretary handling human resource, and that's, I believe, USEC Ronquillo before. I don't know who's handling that now. Yan ang nag-aalaga ng mga benefits. And it's all there. Regular na ini-implement yan. So I believe that is coming from the fact that there has been a constant nuance between the Alliance of Healthcare Workers and some of the military officers. Yan ang pwedeng, in fact, that is one thing, Karen, na nakuha rin ng attention ng ating mga scientists and doctors. Pag may mga demonstrations, pag merong mga guluhan, doctors were not trained to be negotiators. So when they go on the negotiating table, nakakain, nawawalan ng solusyon. I'm not sure, maybe the former PNP general would have had experience a lot of negotiations. In that case, siya ang pwedeng umupo at kausapin yung opposing groups. Because sa mga hospitals, marami yan eh. Ito yung isang grupo.
Pero ano ba talaga, since you have been there yourself, educate all of us. Ano ba ang silbi ng undersecretary sa DOH?
I mean, depende po kasi.
Are they only political appointees to grant political favors pag pinakiusapan? Or do they really serve a genuine purpose in furthering the health agenda of the country?
Yeah, Karen, if I am looking at the Department of Health, most of those appointed are not political appointees. I'm not sure if General Cascolan is a political appointee because I have not seen him very active in the political world. He's not also a politician. I would look at it at the other perspective that he has been appointed because of his management skills. Hindi kasi madaling maghanap ng manager. It's easy to get inputs from a lot of experts. But managing the situation, having that implemented, and seeing to it that things that should be delivered to every Filipino family is done, that's something. And I'm hoping that General Cascolan, if ever he will be given the task, can deliver. Now, nagkaroon na kasi kaagad ng notion na hindi, in-appoint yan, political appointee. But these are people who are also probably applying, or ito yung mga, the problem is, wala pa nga, hindi pa na, I mean, I'm not talking about General Cascolan alone. I'm talking about all the other people na pag in-appoint sa gobyerno, pinupuno na kaagad ng criticism. Why don't we give those people a chance to serve, observe them, let's say, 100 days, 1 year, and if they're not performing, they can be changed anytime. Mm-hmm. Let's say I'm a doctor. I mean, my expertise is on advanced vaccinology and public health. Mm-hmm. I'm in the Department of Health. Let's say I am director for. I will be offered the position of undersecretary. Will I accept it? Of course, I will think twice because my term ends in 6 years, hopefully. Pero pwede ka kasing matanggal after 2 years. Well, yeah. As director four, you can, let's talk about OIC Secretary Rosette Verheri. She is undersecretary, but she can actually sustain 3 presidents with her age because she is career. So if she is appointed as Secretary of Health, it also means that she is willing to give up her post anytime. Remember, she is not practicing in the hospitals dahil sa DOH na siya lumaki. She rose from the ranks. So if she will be appointed as Secretary of Health, it goes with it that she is ready to let go of government service after 6 years. Or she is ready to be removed anytime by the president. Or she is ready not to be confirmed by the commission on appointments. These are situations that many of the people are not seeing. Res, maraming qualified, pero halos walang gusto because of the vulnerability of having cases. And it's not a joke.
So Congresswoman, this is interesting. Is it fair to say that by Secretary OIC Secretary Verheri remaining as officer in charge, to a degree, is the president doing her a favor?
Well, coming from the Department of Health, though,
you
weigh the pros and cons. Yusek Verheri has how many kids? 3 kids. Puro yan nag-aaral. Let's say, example, pagdating sa commission on appointments, pag hindi siya ma-confirm, then she becomes jobless. Or let's say naman, magaling ang performance niya. Natapos niya 6 years. On that 6 year, with her age, is she ready to give up government service? That's also one of the factors. But not only that, marami rin, when we talk about DOH positions, nung pinayagan, nakasuhan ang mga doktor right and left, that actually gave a very bad signal to our experts. Ang dami-daming ino-offera ng mga post, bakit ayaw tumanggap? Ang karamihan nila kasi sagot, nako baka ma-dengvax siya kami, nako baka ma-COVID kami, nako may procurement. And others would like to be appointed, but they would like it to be specifically mentioned in their appointment papers that they will not be obliged to handle any procurement activity. But the problem is, any USEC that are ASEC appointed, wala kang choice. Kung hindi maging part ka ng bids and awards committee. So the risk is very high. Probably with a former general coming into the picture, hindi siya basta-basta pwedeng kuyugin ng mga, let's say, mga magugulong businessmen or minsan, I'm not generalizing the idea, but some are lawyers are also very difficult to handle na pag hindi mo pinagbigyan, kaso ng kaso ng kaso. And this is a situation that most doctors do not like. Why? Because we also get a lot of offers from other countries. And mind you, Karen, in other countries, the doctor, especially if you're working with the government, are extremely protected. Pag kinasuhan ka, especially if it's from a government agency, the executive comes out and protects you.
Okay. All right. Actually, this is such an interesting discussion. We can talk about this at length. And I wanted to ask you even about the bivalent COVID-19 vaccine. So we'll have you on another show for that. But I think your message is clear, Congresswoman Garin. Your message simply is give Kaskolan a chance. That's your message. Give him a chance.
Give DOH a chance.
Okay, give DOH a chance. Thank you so much for joining me today. Iloilo Representative Janet Garin, also former health secretary. Thank you, ma'am. I'll see you again on the show.
Thank you, Karen. God
bless. As always, God bless you.